talk a lot about breathing efficiently to improve sleep, to have better stress resilience, and to feel less breathless with exercise. Well, how can you assess that? Unfortunately, at the current time, we don't have an agreed, simple one way of doing this. And I believe this is because there are different ways of breathing inefficiently. So I'm going to give you three ways that you could consider using. The first one is to consider how often you use your mouth to breathe. The only role the mouth has in breathing is to make it inefficient. So are you using it to breathe when perhaps you're distracted at the computer, watching the TV, on your phone, walking to the car, walking up the stairs, walking around the supermarket? The second way is to consider how you breathe when you're asleep. Your breathing pattern when asleep is your unconscious breathing pattern. So it tells you or gives you an indication of how efficient you're breathing. Are you using your mouth to breathe whilst asleep? Well, how would you know this? The things that would suggest this is if when you wake up, your mouth's open, you feel your mouth is incredibly dry on wakening, you feel unrefreshed when you wake up, your pillow has got lots of saliva on it, you have nasal congestion on wakening, or you're coughing or wheezing when you wake up. All these things are suggesting your mouth is open when asleep. If you have a sleeping partner, maybe they could look if your mouth is open when you're asleep. The other thing is if your breathing is noisy when asleep, you're snoring or you've got gaps in breathing. All this again suggests your breathing is not as efficient as it could be. The third way is to use the assessment suggested by Kiesel and colleagues in their paper. So this is measuring a comfortable breath hold time and asking four questions. So the breath hold time is a comfortable breath hold time. So you keep your mouth closed throughout the assessment, you have some access to a clock, maybe on your phone. You take a small silent breath in through your nose, a small silent breath out through your nose, and you pinch and hold, and you press the timer to start. And you just wait. You should have enough oxygen in your body with a breath hold of this type, so it's not your oxygen that's going to drop. What will happen is your carbon dioxide will be increasing because you're not releasing it, because you're holding your breath, and your body will send a signal to breathe once you reach your personal tolerance level to this, and you will feel a muscle spasm, like a squeeze in your throat or in your diaphragm, which is underneath your ribs. And then you let go and you note the time. This isn't a maximum breath hold, it's a comfortable breath hold. So you're just waiting just for that signal to breathe. So your breathing should generally be comfortable afterwards. And then the four questions they suggest are, do you feel tense? Do you yawn? Do you have cold hands and feet? And do you use your mouth to breathe? So if you answer often or very often to one of those questions and the breath hold time is less than 25 seconds, that can be an indicator that you're not breathing as efficiently as you could be. So those are three ways, and I think they're reasonable ways to try and understand if you are breathing inefficiently. I remember when I first recognised that I was breathing inefficiently. I had started snoring in my perimenopause, and I actually remember feeling quite a negative response when the consideration of, well, I'm not breathing efficiently. I had a healthy weight and I was running three times a week. I felt there was no problem with my breathing. But when I truly thought about it, I clearly wasn't breathing efficiently because I was snoring and I wasn't feeling refreshed on wakening and I had a very dry mouth. I improved my breathing efficiency, and now I can do all my running with nasal breathing. I feel much more calmer in control, and I sleep so much better. Hence why I still work as a GP, but I also work as a breathing practitioner now, because I want others to gain and to feel that benefit of improving breathing efficiency. If you would like me to be your guide, I have individual and group programs. The details are on my website, and I have a group program starting soon.